Hey, what's up guys, it's Fish here and welcome back to another mod spotlight video for Total War Warhammer. Today we're going to be taking a look at a new mini campaign which has just gone and hit the Steam Workshop. This is called the Storm of Chaos and it goes ahead and completely changes the Beastmen mini campaign which was previously in the game. So you do need the Beastmen DLC to be able to play this. However, I think it's completely worth it. It completely revamps the actual campaign itself and makes it more of a kind of chaos invasion of that territory. And you as Middleheim, and I think you have a Cult of Sigmar and some other factions as well, which you have to go ahead and try and prevent the Storms of Chaos from just taking over the world. I have a list of everything this mod adds. And it goes ahead and adds in 3 more playable factions, 2 more legendary lords, 2 heroes, 2 legendary heroes, all with their own custom skill trees, as well as 4 new quest battles, each with their own custom map battles, 3 new technology trees, 7 buildings, and over 50 units. So it is a complete overhaul mod, which changes so goddamn much. I mean, there's 50 new units, which is pretty crazy. That's like a large amount of units for each faction. So yeah, what I thought we'd do today is just kind of jump into a campaign, maybe mess around with one of the factions and then just kind of leave it there and get a good battle in so you guys can see what some of the new custom units look like and then just leave it there. However, if you guys really want me to continue this on as a proper let's play, then say maybe if this video gets like 800 likes, then I'll do so. I know that's a crazy amount of likes, but I already have one let's play going, so only if you guys really want to see this, I'll go and do it. So you know, if you do, make sure to hit that like button, and if it hits that number, then I will go ahead and continue this on as a proper campaign. So as I said, it is the Storms of Chaos. Archaon is approaching, and the once loyal priests of Sigmar are now starting to get turned to the evil forces. So you can see that the 3 new factions which he has added is the Cult of Sigmar. These guys get 2 legendary heroes, Luther Huss and Voltren, with upgrades, actions, and powerful skill trees. I don't actually know much about these guys at all, so if you guys want to educate me down below in the comments, then please feel free to do so. And also, as well as that, they have no access to magic, but a variety of defensive battle prayers. So they kind of go that more, that focus of actually having the battle prayers more than anything else than, say, magic. They also have flimsy core units, but they're cheap and easy to recruit, and they also have some really good artillery as well. We look at Middleheim, they receive money from other factions which will provide them with funding for their armies. They have a strong and high level capital city to begin with a strong garrison, so they have a really nice position to kind of push out of. And this trailer keeps playing, it's kind of annoying when I'm trying to run through the actual stats. They also have access to both Empire and Cult of Ulrich roster, so they can kind of really push out this really strong army. As well as that, we have the Cult of Ulrich, who are the last playable faction, obviously besides the Warherd and the Empire, as Kolfranz and Kazrak. But we also have the Cult of Ulrich, which has the Lore of Beast and Heavens, access to the powers of nature and the Dark World Forest. Priest Oryx, and they have them the mighty White Wolf infantry and powerful agents as well. They have sturdy line infantry and heavy cavalry with powerful offensive capabilities, but no flying units. So I think we're going to start off by playing as the Cult of Ulrich, because I think they have some really cool starting units. So they have, obviously this is Balthazar Gelt right here, but the actual legendary lord is different. Emil Valgir, I think is how you pronounce it. Maybe just butchered it, but again, let me know what he's about, because I'm always interested in finding out more about these heroes. So they're kind of, his beginning powers are that he's a powerful leader and melee fighter, and can unlock powerful battle prayers as well. We get immune to attrition, which is really nice actually, leadership during forest battles, and speed for melee infantry. We start off getting the children of Ulrich, Wolfkin, and some warriors of Ulrich as well. So some really strong infantry units. So let's just jump into it and see what this campaign is all about. Obviously, I assume we're gonna be getting the Beastmen DLC, or is this a custom trailer?
From the north, it comes.
I think this is just the Chaos intro, right?
The tendrils of chaos spread south.
Which is pretty fitting, right? This is actually a fitting trailer.
And with it, the warriors of chaos march. We must ready ourselves, for war is coming. But who has brought the warring tribes together? What manner of champion holds that power?
So So that was awesome. I really, really like how that the modder has used that. He said he took him about 6 months to create this campaign, and it's still very much not finished. I think he said because there's still a load of issues with a few of the campaign. I think the Beastmen start positions are a bit messed up, so we can't change where any of these factions start, which is really unfortunate. I also like the fact that we get these custom load screens. Again, this is something which is really small in these mods, and I imagine only takes a couple seconds to do. But I feel like it's really, really nice to see these custom backgrounds. They really do just kind of get you immersed into the actual campaign itself. Okay guys, so we have loaded into the campaign right now, and as I mentioned, I don't think we get to change our starting position, but it's still nice to go ahead and start off here. I believe we get a couple turns to kind of prepare our armies and form up, and then the storms of chaos occur and they come pouring in to attack us. So I think, I guess, as we start off, we can take a quick look at some of the units. We get the Wolfkin, the Warriors of Ulric, and the Children of Ulric as well. We obviously have our legendary lord right here. Do we get to, does he have like a custom model on the campaign map or not? He does as well. That looks amazing. That looks really, really cool. I can't wait to see what he is made of. Can we see what his, if he has any cool skills? Because I'm pretty sure he does have a custom tree up here at least. Yeah, he has some really, really good battle prayers up here. Oh my god, some of his battle prayers are amazing. Oh my god, that is really, really good. Leader of the pack, I wonder what that does. Can we see what that does or not? It's hard. I want to see what that does, but it doesn't show me what the leader of a pack ability does, because I can't. It's like appears down there, but I can't go over quick enough. And I think some of these are a bit different as well. Maybe I don't know if some of them are different. I think there might be the Boris Todbringer ones. So we're moving back into our city. We have 10 grand, and we are making a load of money to begin with. There's also custom buildings as well, which I think maybe these statue or these. These ones of Ulric right here are maybe custom ones. What other buildings do we have which are custom? I think some of these maybe are as well. The gunsmith could be. Allows us to have some pretty nice units. What happens if we build in this? Oh, we've already got this one? Yeah, we've already got this building. So I guess we'll go ahead and get a gunsmith to allow us to get some handguns. But then again, I wouldn't mind actually getting to upgrade this and getting some of these Wolfkin and Warriors of Ulric straight off the bat. So I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go ahead and pick up that. It's pretty expensive, but I think it'll be worth it. We'll also upgrade our quarry as well. Or should we just look to get some more economic buildings here? You know, a tap room could be kind of good. Or a weaver's house. Let's pick up a weaver's house here just to help out with our economy. And then I think the rest of our money has to be spent on building up an army. So we have some Middleheim militia. We have some Winter Wolves of Middleheim. Some Huntsmen. And some Swords of Ulric. So I guess we'll pick up some Swords of Ulric just to begin. How many? So we can recruit 4. I think that's going to be nice for our initial starting battle line. Because we do need to make sure we prepare our forces as soon as possible. Oh, look at it. Look how cool this is as well. The custom technology tree. This is absolutely awesome. So do we have to start off here? How do we get on this top of this tree? And how do we move down as well? Because there's some technology I can't get to right now. Why is it unlocked right now? I think we have to get... Yeah, this doesn't really do a good job. Oh, okay, don't worry, actually. So that's just kind of the bottom of the tree, and this is the top of the tree, right? Or maybe not. No. This is just kind of cut out a bit of the tree, okay? So this is a little bit messy, I think, because this is like here, and so is this. Like, all of these are down here, but these are all different as well. So maybe, okay, maybe it's just, yeah, it's a little bit weird. But I'm sure it'll take a couple seconds to get used to, but I'm sure it'll make sense eventually when you kind of mess around with it and spend a little bit more time. But that's amazing. Loads of technology right here to mess around with, and I'm sure it'll be a lot more obvious once I've recruited this, once I've got this technology, and I can see a bunch more of the technology on the screen. So we'll get that. Let's look at diplomacy, see if we have anything crazy. So we don't start off at war with anyone. However, we do have orcs down to the south, the Black Pit tribe. So does anyone want to obviously make friends with us? Because obviously chaos is coming, boys, so we do want to become friends. And I do know that there are a ton of like new events in the mod itself, which come up and kind of lead the story, which is great. I love events which pop up, you know. I want as many, well, maybe not as many events, but I would love events to come up, you know, as much as they do in, say, like, Crusader Kings 2. Just having stuff pop up which adds a lot of flavor to the actual campaign itself. Do you want some money? I mean, I guess this is all doesn't really matter because I'm probably not going to be continuing this campaign on. So let's continue the battle. We need to do an edict. Are there new edicts in the mod itself? There are some new edicts by the looks of it as well. I guess we'll pick up the public order one just because I obviously want the city to be happy. So hopefully we get some battles, and if worse comes to worse, we can either always move forward and attack the Black Pit. and try and get rid of him. But hopefully we get some good events popping up. So yeah, this does make a lot more sense now, we can see. So more recruits or recruitment cost. I guess we'll get more experience for our recruits. We'll pick that up and continue just to, you know, build up our soldiers right here. Keep on boosting up verve and power of these soldiers. So I guess we'll pick up some huntsmen now, just to act as our missile force. I'm sure that'll be good.
I will listen.
Middleheim, what do you want, good sir? You want a non-aggression pact? Of course. Of course, Boris, we will have a non-aggression. Nice, got that, so that'll give us experience. So, Twin Tail Comet, a shining object flew across the night sky. That's awesome. So this is just kind of, you know, speaking of omens, and apparently there's a load more of these flavor events which do pop up and show some cool abilities. So our army can always, yeah, just push on the orcs if we want to, which I might do because I'm not sure how long it takes for the chaos to turn up. I was told it only takes up a couple turns until the chaos do like appear and start causing havoc. Oh my god, look at these guys as well, the Children of Ulric. I only have 12 people in the unit. I want to see what they look like, because I think that would be amazing. I'm going to get a couple units of Middleheim Militia, just because they're really cheap, and then just get some more Sword Infantry, and then we'll get ready to push on, I think. We could also talk about, because we're upgrading this, maybe we'll wait until we get some better units there. Some Reichsguard, the Knights of a White Wolf are our best cavalry force. Oh, these are just Empire Knights, actually. So I guess we'll just, you know, keep on our economy going for now. Oh, we could upgrade this, get some more. Oh my god, oh my god, these guys look sick. 100 of them in a unit. They have 95 armor. Oh my lord, what do they need? I wonder what they need. They need a better armory. So let's build that up and then we'll save up for a better armory. And hopefully we'll maybe be able to get them in this mini playthrough. So melee attack when attacking on land. That's pretty good. We'll pick that up and you can see it starting to move down here. So I think the tree is just kind of a bit too big to fit on the map in its completeness. But hopefully he'll be able to work that out going forward. But we also have officers as well, which is kind of cool. I didn't realize that was in the actual game itself, but that's cool nonetheless. Does this give a boost or not? Can we go to our tree? Or is that... I kind of don't even know how to use it. I like barely ever played as the Empire itself. So we have to destroy these guys, which I guess are our initial people we have to go after. And then we have to destroy the chaos when they pour in as well. So we have to recruit a hero. We can do that. And it'll be cool to see what the hero looks like on the campaign map as well. Just pick up one. A Priest of Ulric with his Colfran's position. Any good ones? That one's pretty good. Yeah, let's pick up this one then.
Strengthen the Empire.
We see him on the campaign map. Oh, he's a custom model as well on the campaign map. That looks great. He's just like a warrior priest, right? He looks cool nonetheless, so we'll stick him in our army. We have a few more slots left for our infantry, I guess. So I guess we'll pick up... We already have 4 units of archers. I guess we'll pick up some of these Winter Wolves of Middleheim, maybe, as like cavalry. And then just maybe another unit of archers. And then our hero can move in. And then we can push on. But granted, we are getting this next turn as well, so... If we hold up, yeah, let's hold up quickly. We'll get some of them. Maybe we'll get rid of some of these militia. I don't know. We'll see what we can get. We'll continue to work down here during forest battles, weapon strength for all units when fighting chaos. Let's get the recruitment cost. Yeah, let's get the recruitment cost. I like how quickly these technologies are. I think that's pretty awesome. So will to fight, which is up. Great, great, great. That pushes us onto this. Gives us melee defense when all win defending. That's pretty good. I'll pick that up. If you guys want to skip straight to the battle, I'll leave a skip to battle button in the comments, maybe, so you guys can pick that up. I just want to make sure I had some decent units. So here we go. We have some proper wolfkin here. And all the units we got to from the beginning, right? Oh, these guys have like no armor, but I imagine they're pretty good. So let's pick up another unit of Warriors of Ulric, I think would be cool. Because they actually got, there's a lot of them in the unit as well. And then obviously our priest can also move into the army as well.
To strengthen the Empire.
So next time this army will march. I guess we can march it now almost. So we just get closer to their armies. And then we'll be able to get a nice little battle with them, which will be great. So let's go ahead and... I would prefer to get a land battle, if I'm honest. But if we have to fight a siege battle, that's fine. I don't think we have any, like... I don't think we have a ton of custom map battles in this mod at the moment, either. Oh my god. And oh, this is not good. So Kislev has been destroyed, right? The helpless hordes of chaos at the gates. Yeah, so chaos is basically just ripping through Kislev as we speak. And we have to get ready to prepare. So I imagine over here, like Kislev's like over here, right? Or maybe up here. Yeah, Kislev's like over here more right. So we got Hochland, yeah. So Kislev's all the way like over here off the map, which we can't really see. But the enemy are pouring in slowly but surely, coming closer and closer to us. So at least we're like the other side and don't have to worry too much. But our army is ready to move. Let's go ahead and get closer and closer and then just declare war on them. Because I want to see what these units look like. Because they're going to all have custom models and everything like that. So it's all going to be awesome. I guess we can boost that up as well, as we've got some more money as well. We might as well do all of that as well. So continue down our technology tree, cheaper units or more money from looting. Or we could go down this. I mean, none of these are really that great. We also have some new technology up here, do we? Yeah, this is all the same tech, which is like, yeah, this tech goes here, that tech goes there. So yeah, they're the same tech tree. This is just showing the bottom half of it. It shouldn't have taken me that long. I kind of knew it, but I thought there was maybe some a few different techs up here. But you can see they're exactly the same. So let's continue on down there. It's still awesome that, you know, that each one of these factions has its own tech tree. That's really awesome. Shows a lot of work has been going into the mod itself. So these guys have risen up a pretty nice force. Let's declare war on them.
Attack!
The battle! Oh god, they must have an amazing garrison. They do indeed. I wouldn't mind them actually sallying forth then and fighting me. Because I'd love to fight a land battle against them. They have so many missiles as well. Luckily, oh, they have so many missiles, Jesus. I mean, we'll just build some siege towers and stuff like that. But we'll just chill out. And if they don't want to attack me, then maybe we can just, you know, fuck. Because hopefully they'll, like, sally forth against me this turn. Yeah, exactly what they do. So this is awesome. This has turned out really good. Because I don't think that's a custom map battle right there. I think that is just, you know, a normal Warhammer siege, which isn't that fun. So yeah, we get to fight a good battle on top of a hill. This will be great. We might get absolutely annihilated here because they have a large garrison. But it'll still be a fun battle nonetheless, and we get to see what some of these Cult of Auric units look like. So hopefully so far during this kind of spotlight video, you guys have got a really good idea of the mod itself. You've seen some flavor events. I'm sure there's plenty of like missions you get given. I think the mod itself, you know, that's one of the stuff it prizes itself on, is having a ton of missions and kind of more direction for stuff for you to do in the actual campaign, which is great news. I'm really excited to see what these units look like. Especially my legendary lord, like on the battlefield with his battle prayers. I'm just hoping that I have a strong enough army to kind of withstand the assault coming towards us, because that's going to be pretty dangerous. It's kind of embarrassing if we lose this battle, but I'm sure, you know, it doesn't really matter. Unless you guys hit that like target and I'll be continuing on, and maybe it won't look too good then, but I'm sure it'll be absolutely fine. Okay, guys, we are in the battle itself now, so let's get a good eye look at some of these units. Oh, crap, look at these bad boys right now. So they've used the Vargolf unit as these Children of Ulric. Damn, these guys look crazy. That's amazing. Considering that the modders can't add in, like, any new, like, models or anything like that, I think they've done a great job there. The Swords of Ulric right here as well, looking nice indeed. And do remember, like, these modders can't add in any assets which aren't already in the game, so they kind of had to use what they have. I think these Warriors of Ulric look amazing. These guys look sick. They've definitely done a great job at kind of making these guys look really unique. That's for sure. What else do we have? We have our legendary lord right here as well. He looks pretty basic, you know, like he's not like a super crazy armor or anything like that. He's just chilling, you know. He's just like, yeah, let's go, I'm ready to kill anyone. We have our warrior priest right here helping us out. He's looking good. We have some of our Middleheim militia. Just basic spearmen, basically, but in the Middleheim stuff. Then we also have some of our Wolfkin. Wow, the Wolfkin look great. Look how big them hammers are. Are they like Black Orc hammers? They look like Dwarven hammers, which have been enlarged. Or axes, I should say. Yeah, these guys, the Wolfkin look great. I like that a lot. Obviously, we have our wolves as well. That's amazing. What wolf text? What? How did they get this? Like these wolfkin look great. What did they use to get these guys? That's really cool. And then obviously we have our huntsmen, which I imagine are like a mix of peasant bowmen and a few other units. But again, they've got some really nice models which they've used to create them. So cool, let's go ahead and form up this army and get ready to withstand the orc oncoming herd. So let's form up our archers, which do actually have vanguard mode. We'll see these guys on the front line. We'll have our war beast on this left flank. Our swords holding the center. We'll stick some spearmen on this left flank. I'm just honestly very scared of their missiles. They have a ton of missiles. If we get locked into melee combat, I'm sure we'll win the day. But it's actually getting into melee combat, which is going to be our issue. Obviously, these guys as well, the Sons of Ulric, are just going to slaughter anyone. So hopefully we can win this day. We'll let the enemy bring on their reinforcements. They might not even decide to bring on their reinforcements, if I'm honest. They might just decide just to kind of push forward. That's not the locked formation I wanted, actually. Why isn't the lock in their formation? There we go. That's what we wanted. So let's rotate our army just around a little bit, just so we're a bit more, you know, facing out the enemy, push forward. There's no new orc units in this, I don't think, but obviously the Chaos and all of the Empire and Middleheim and all them other factions have plenty of new custom units to bring on to see. So it's kind of unfortunate we don't get to see the Chaos units, but maybe we can just jump out after this and have a quick look at the custom battles, as well as we get to see these Swords of Ulrich get ready to go up against the oncoming orc forces. I'm actually going to bring back my archers a little bit as well. I feel like these guys are a little bit exposed here. Let's just run back, form up, get ready to push back the enemy advance. The orc boar boys are going to be my main issue, but the archers should be out enough to put down the hurt on the enemy lines. I really don't want my forces to actually engage these boar boys as well. I feel like my wolves are just going to get absolutely smashed. We have our spearmen on this right flank. I'd much prefer to have them on the left flank, because our wolves are going to actually have to commit into this engagement. Maybe we can bring in our general as well. Bring back our archers now. God, the archers are doing great damage to the enemy forces. Ah, it's a beautiful charge by the wolves, but I feel like the orc boys are doing a great job of taking me down. Actually, we're doing a pretty good job now. We're formed up fully. Archers are falling back. The main line is getting ready to engage. I guess if I supported them maybe with another unit, we would have done a good job. We need our archers to turn around and start picking away at their missiles now. Start killing their archers and we'll be in a good situation, I think. These wolves are going to come round and hit the enemy lines. Do some nice little slow-mo as these guys come flying in. The wolves just ripping apart. Oh my god, look at these guys. They have like some... They get special markings when they go into battle, maybe? That's really cool. I like how they change once they go into battle. That is sick. That's really, really cool. We're actually going to rout these guys. Should have done that a long time ago. The infantry has now engaged. We've got our cult of Ulrich swordsmen up against the orc biguns right now. Lots of missile fire going off. I guess we'll form these guys up, get these guys around the flank to move in. We'll have our battle priests go in as well as bringing up some of these guys. I mean, I imagine our wolves will now be able to rip apart these archer forces, which are becoming a nuisance. We'll get our general involved as well in these engagements as soon as we can. The archers should just be on guard mode though. Don't run after the enemy. And we'll get some of our more elite units stuck in as well. Obviously, we've got all these soldiers over to this right-hand side as well we have to worry about. So we do have to be somewhat careful. But we'll get these guys stuck in now and watch them charge as the rest of these wolves come flying in against the enemy lines. Yeah, we've been getting shot to pieces back here. Oh my god, the archer fire for these warriors of Ulrich have been brutal. But look at the way these guys run into battle. That's spectacular right there. That guy's taking an arrow to the thigh and still charging on. These guys look amazing as they move into battle. That is great. We have our children of Ulrich right there as well, smashing into the side here. Awesome. The wolves should be more than enough just to run down these archers. We have to be careful of the trolls coming in, but, you know, overall we should be fine here. Got our archers moving on to his right flank to help out. I guess we'll just send in more of his infantry to keep pushing on the enemy lines. I want to kind of get these axemen in the back of the enemy lines as well. That'd be great. Okay, let's turn around and start hitting more of our archers now. My own archers can again start focusing down these guys. How are the Sons of Ulrich doing? Let's zoom in on these guys. Are they in the front lines yet? They're just about up against some nasty skulkers. So let's move up a little bit closer. Go ahead and click play on the battlefield now. And watch these guys fight hard. Oh my god, look at this, my battle priest right there. My warriors of Ulrich. How are the other guys doing? They're making their way around yet? They are indeed. Let's get these guys to charge into the back of the enemy lines. That'll be spectacular. Yeah, continue to chase them down, wolfies. The trolls are actually coming. We have to be careful with the trolls. Oh, here we go. I know we're in an awful formation, but look at them coming to this charge. Let's go, boys, to the front lines. Oh, they like to swing their axes like black orcs right there. That's great. And we're going to be pushing back that entire line, right? We are indeed. Archers are focusing these guys down. You guys are chasing down their archers, even though there's plenty of enemy forces there. So let's reform, boys. Reform the line. We pretty much won there. General can come back. All these guys can come back as well. Reform the line as we do. Archers can keep on moving up, focusing down over here. We can bring him back now. We've still got plenty of enemy forces still left to come. You're going to be killing them, which is fine. If you can engage them, wolfies, do that. Yeah, because the wolves, I imagine, will be able to wreck the enemy boars here. So if you guys can get involved, do get involved. Chase them down. Do some damage. Our archers should be enough to kill the rest of the enemy forces over here. The boar boys, etc. Let's send some spearmen just to go help them out as well. Why the hell not? Infantry line is reformed. We've actually got some troll on Sons of Ulrich action right now. I think my units are winning. These guys are really strong. As well as that, we've got the, what are these guys called? The Axemen. Are these just warriors? Oh, these are Wolfkin, sorry. Let's bring back the Wolfkin as well. We'll get ready to receive the next enemy army as they get closer and closer. Archers are continuing to shoot. Some nasty skulkers over here, which are fine. Don't really faze me. Yeah, nice. Routed them. Now we can chase down the rest of their missiles. You guys go shoot that. You wolves can chase down their archers there. We actually got some more wolves back here as well, which we can definitely use. Oh, trolls smashing into my front line here. Let's use some wolfkin. I wonder if these guys are like anti-large or anything. If we take a look. So these guys are armor piercing. These, yeah, they're all damage dealers and armor piercing. So no anti-large or anything like that. I imagine the spearmen probably are. These are decent melee and expendable. Let's move in the axemen to try and fight these guys. Obviously, we have our generals back there as well. We have to be somewhat careful of. Again, just continuing to chase them down. These guys can turn and start shooting their missiles again. I think we just like move out and help out these archers now. Let's charge forward. I feel pretty confident in this battle with our forces as are. Let's push out and let's go and take the engagement to the enemy now. Even though advanced power is definitely not in my favor still, we've got this, I think. Especially with these elite units as well. Obviously, we have our general and the fanatics are ripping through my lines, though. That's not what we want to see. Bring up our general as well. Bring up these archers to go ahead and hit their missiles. These wolves have finally managed to deal with them, so let's bring the wolf back in. Our own archers are wrecking the enemy line. Okay, let's go ahead and see some of these soldiers now. Oh my god, they are just... The children of Ulrich are just so powerful right now. The warriors of Ulrich as well with their double like hammers are just... Oh my god, that missile fire though. Oh my lord, that missile fire. We need to get stuck in as soon as possible. Our left flank is also not looking great for us. We need these wolves in here as soon as we can to chase them down. Because that missile fire is insane. Our general as well can get involved. Go fight their general, please. We need to be taking out their missiles. Like, really, really badly. Holy crap. That was insane the amount of damage their missiles just did. We got some wolves coming. These wolves need to come back. I swear I gave the order for these guys to come back a while ago. We need our general here to hit their general. A few more wolves chasing down some of their soldiers. Hopefully that will give our infantry time to fight them. We have our own legendary lord there. More missile fire coming in though. Holy crap. Missile superiority right here. The left flank is starting to crumble, which is not good. That is not good at all. We need these wolves back here as soon as we can. So many missiles and we don't have much armor, which is a real issue. Even these guys, these children of Ulrich are starting to struggle a little bit. Archers continue to shoot. These wolves should definitely help us out a bit. Continue to hit their general. Oh, the trolls in the back of the archers, though. That's not good at all. Archers come back, hit their missiles. You guys go ahead and hit these guys. Oh, we have some infantry coming back from routing. Perfect. You guys go straight to the front. Nice. We've actually managed to push back this entire cavalry line there. So I think this faction, you definitely want to get a lot more cavalry. Like a lot more of these wolf riders. And obviously don't commit the wolf riders early. Our general though is full health and he's about to rout one of the enemy generals. That is good. That is very, very good. Wolf riders continue just to chase down their missiles, stop them from shooting, give us a chance. Oh, them trolls though are just smashing away our warriors. How are the wolfkin doing? Wolfkin, how you doing, boys? Keep pushing forward. Yeah, we're routing some of their infantry. Their general's routing, which is great news. Keep pushing him back. If we can kill him, that'd be perfect. Wolves are now just, you know, ripping apart these night goblins. I imagine they are going to be losing numbers at some time, like, you know, slowly. They're getting shot to pieces as well, which is not good. This has definitely been a hard battle. I definitely would have brought more troops, or at least a better army, to the battle the next time. Our general, though, is just unkillable right now. How's the enemy morale looking? I mean, they're all exhausted. We just need our soldiers to hold firm, really. Keep our missile fire going. Bring back these guys, get them to start shooting the giants. I think we're going to get a mass rout here going on, though. But it's still been a really, really cool battle to show you guys how everything's worked. I could have obviously have won this battle as well, maybe if I try harder a little bit more. Or maybe not obviously. You know, I feel like I definitely could have won this battle if I was, you know, being a little bit more cautious with my men and not talking to you guys. And not showing cinematic shots like that. I really like the shields on the back of these archers as well. These guys are great. Oh no, oh no, that does not look great though. Where's our general? Being smashed apart by these fanatics, but he's still fighting on. Surrounded, but he is mighty and will not give up without a fight. He is going to rout those. Cool. I think that's enough for showing you guys that. So let's end the battle. We'll jump out of it. We'll quickly run over the custom maps quickly. Or not the custom maps, but we'll quickly run over the actual custom units. So we'll go and jump into custom battle. Yeah. Imagine if I would have had like 4 units of these wolves instead of maybe these militia right here. That would have been sick. That would have been so much better to run down all their archers. As I forget how many archers the AI actually brings is pretty dumb. I normally play with a AI recruitment mod. Okay guys, so what we'll do now is we'll quickly run through the units that you guys may not have seen. We're just going to run through it in this screen. We're not going to jump into battle or anything, just so you guys have a better idea at some of the units which are going to be in the game, in the campaign itself. So we'll start off with the Cult of Sigmar. We didn't see any of them units. They're obviously led by Volkmar, who is their legendary lord. They get the 2 awesome looking heroes right here, who are obviously very powerful, having lots of HP. They also get some access to gun caps and these Crimson Defiance, which are pretty cool. Also a load of flagellants and other units we already see in the game. They have access to the Surefires and a ton of heavy cavalry. Hunters of Sigmar, they get Knights of the Hammers of Sigmar, they get Knights of the Twin Tail Orb, and just plenty more heavy cavalry to be using in the Cult of Sigmar. So I imagine they kind of like play a bit like Bretonnia in a sense. So they have kind of weak infantry, but their cavalry makes up for it. They obviously also get access to the Lemanarchs. Cult of Ulrich as well, we guys saw pretty much all of their units. I think there was a few units like these guys we didn't get to see, as well as obviously their late heavy cavalry. We got to see pretty much everything. So cool, that is the mod. I believe there is Middleheim as well, but I think they just have the same units as the other people, as the Empire, maybe with a few different additions, but I can't actually select them here. So that's kind of weird. But yeah, that was the campaign. Hopefully you guys enjoyed that kind of mini look at it. It was awesome to see a custom campaign with that much flavor and missions and customization and stuff like that. Basically just does completely revamp the actual campaign itself. So really awesome. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to drop a like and a comment down below. And I'll see you guys next time, and fish out.